Hi, my name is Ilma, and this is my truth blog for the day. It's from Psalm 98. It says, "Make a joyful noise to the Lord. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made known his salvation. He has revealed his righteousness in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of melody, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who dwell in it. Let the river clasp their hands. Let the hills sing for joy together before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity." That's from Psalm 98, 1-9. Commentary. This psalm is a celebration of God's marvelous deeds for his people. The psalm reminds me of New Year's celebration in my country of origin, the Philippines. Filipinos celebrate the coming of the year with a big bang, loud firecrackers and fireworks that probably last for a minimum of an hour, and a maximum of 4 hours or more. Why can't we do that for God who made all things? This psalm shouts and gives praises to the Lord who granted deliverance for the house of Israel. It also tells the whole world that God can do the same for all nations, and it invites all people to praise the Lord. Adoration. Shout and make noises to rejoice, because the Lord is good. Praise him forever. He delivers his people from all evil and brings peace and joy to all mankind. Confession. Forgive me, Lord, when I am not expressing gratitude that declares your love. Thanksgiving. Thank you for being faithful and a promise keeper. Supplication. May all people declare and shout out loud their praises to the Lord. Reflection. Question. Why is rejoicing and making noises to the Lord something all Christians must do? When we become born again, we're given new life. So somebody who has new life, remember, when a baby is born, the first thing it does is to cry out loud, coming out from the womb of their mother. So I think that we should be able to express that joy, that we're going to cry out because we have new life. We're not dead anymore. So people who are dead won't do any noise. They're dead, right? But when you are alive in Christ, in Jesus, you would want to declare and proclaim the glory that has been endowed on you when the Holy Spirit came into your heart when you received him. So it is really an oxymoron when you're a Christian and then you're gloomy and you're depressed and, you know, you're always sad. It's not becoming of Christ, because Christ gives life. So we shouldn't be dead Christians. We should be able to shout out loud and proclaim the goodness of the Lord. So thanks for watching. I hope you check some of my artworks and my website at ilmaarts.com. And I hope that this psalm will give you a new perspective of being a Christian, of shouting out loud to praise the Lord, because worship and giving him the adoration and the adulation and the praise that is only should be given to him, we should all do that. So thanks for watching, and I hope you make a joyful noise to the Lord. each and every day, each and every hour, each and every moment of your life. God bless you. I love you. And so does God.